Very, very warm good morning to each and every one of you. This is the next episode of Pilot Talks.
Pilot ki baat.
Pilot ki baat. How are you, sir? How are you doing today?
Oh, great. Thank you very much. Our last episode was real super duper hit. You know, people saw it so many times on YouTube. I mean, and also people called. And, you know, even Anand Karkare, Captain Karkare was very happy doing the episode, so it was a good idea of yours to call him back again because he hasn't spoken about many things. So let's have him on the show. And you know, I mean, I'm sure your questions are pending from the last time. So we will pick his brain on the pilot training for what he is known in the industry as a great guy. So.
Yes, sir. Yes. Before I do that, I would like to congratulate you for your lovely conversations you had on the IMO, as well as by the Marex Media for being one of the top industry influencers. So, heartiest congratulations.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
All right, everyone. I will introduce Captain Anand Karkare in short again. I have introduced him in the previous episode. Let me just give a short bio of our great personality. He joined Mumbai Port as a pilot in 1990 and he got command of the vessel in 1985 and at the age of 27 years. Self-improvement has always been his mantra, which made him complete the degree course in economics and commerce. He's also a fellow member of Narottam Morarji Institute of Shipping. While serving in Mumbai Port Trust, he also took the opportunity to undertake a year's break to go out to sail. That gave him a different perspective of ship handling and watching other international pilots carrying out pilotage in their respective countries. He was deputed as the chief port officer to Mumbai Maritime Board. In this tenure, he had the opportunity of formulating various policies for development of greenfield ports, ro-ro ferries in creeks, concession agreements, etc. He is presently an advisor to Mumbai Port Trust on marine related issues, especially pilot entry training and career progress training. Some of his achievements, I would say that he is one of the very important role and personality in designing and navigation simulation study of new berths in Mumbai Port and betting of TEFS and DPR submitted by the proponents. So that's a lot, and let's not wait. Let's get Captain Anand Karkare on board and ask him few more questions. One of my favorite question is regarding the pilot training and the induction of pilots, the seafarers, into getting the awareness to become a marine pilot in India.
Yeah, absolutely. Let's welcome Captain Anand Karkare. He's an ardent supporter of MPAM and a guru of pilots.
Thank you so much for coming back to the show.
Good morning.
Thank you very much. It was a very enlightening discussion with the last episode we have, and we are very, very, very happy to call you back again because, you know, your storytelling habit and, you know, your narration was so interesting for the viewers as well. So now it's the time to explore a little more into your most liked area. I mean, Vijay, if you allow me to ask the first question, I will go on to it because the question is also very close to my heart. And of course, I'm past doing. Captain Karkare, you did mention last time about, you when being inducted as a pilot and your training and your training style, those were the days in the ports and pilotage, you know, in way back in 1985 or 1989. Yeah, even I've been around that time as a cadet in Indian ports, and I know the scenario in Indian port that time. So, the pilot training is somehow, you know, is very close to the AMPA's heart because you are aware of it and you've been also have edited our syllabus. What we did is for Ministry of Shipping, we wrote a module-based pilot training program, which is going to be run under the, you know, the auspices of IMU. And Madam VC, Dr. Manish Shankar, has taken it very seriously with the ministry, and soon the program will be rolling for the pilot training, for the newly inducted pilot or entry-level pilot training. Tell us more about it because you have been at the heart of pilot training. You have been trained yourself, of course, but you have also trained a lot of pilots in the Mumbai port. So what is it that, you know, we are not getting there with respect to the pilot training so far?
Thanks for calling me back. Regarding Palakesh training, training is important in all aspects of life. Right from the time we start walking, that also is a training. So training is everywhere important. Now regarding the Palakesh, the system what was being followed in Mumbai Port was when the pilot, of course, the qualification was a master mariner with a certificate of competency as a master. And 6 months after obtaining certificate, you can be a chief officer or a master. It was not important, but only thing, after having got certificate, you had to sail again on the ship for 6 months. That had been the criteria. And the thing was, in such a gradual training, because those days when that formulated this program, it was sometime in 70s or 60s. Those days there was no simulation, pilotage simulation center or nothing. It was just, you observe the senior pilot, how he does the job. He will explain you in short, what is he doing, how to employ the tugs, and that's it. And we had to attend in Mumbai Port 150 ships along with the senior pilot over a period of 6 months. After that, you were put into the tonnage of 4,000 tons, there for 3 months, then 6,000. And this time, as you were carrying the moments, the dock master in each dock, they were kind of an observer, you know, who will report at the end of 4 months, how was your piloting? What are the aspects they found lacking, or whether he needs to be upgraded to 6,000 or he can remain on 4,000 for a little longer. So this is how the thing was. I missed out on that one. Then after the end of the 6 months, there is to be what we call as a first one was a master pilot exam. Means a senior pilot would take our exam. That means he will ask you the entire topography. Means we had to do the topography of the Mumbai port by heart. Like the current moves in this direction and the tides out are in this place. The depth of water is so much over here. The tide moves in that direction. So everything. So those 30, 40 pages, we have to do it by heart. So that was a thing concept. Later on, as you upgraded yourself, and it took almost 3.5 to 4 years, total 4 years, 3.5 years pilotage and 6 months initially for this training. So it was a 4 years of total time till you became a full tonnage pilot or unrestricted tonnage pilot. So that has been the concept going on. It was going on till say about last year or 2 years ago. But with the inception of various courses, what Merchant Navy guys are undergoing, the navigation simulator and all, it has now, we have truncated down to 3 years, 2.5 to 3 years. Of course, this is because of the bridge simulation, the simulators, what we don't have it, but JNPT has it. So with that, people get an experience how to go ahead. Now the question is, you had said whether the training we should go ahead for it. Yes, the concept of earlier training was that pilot who joined, he was already a Merchant Navy master. So when he came here, he came with all that kind of experience on board the ship, whatever. Like say, I just now gave the incidences in the previous episode, how the things work out. So when you join the ship, you are knowingly, unknowingly have accumulated so much of experience that something happens, you are immediately, you know, that kind of a thing triggers into your brain and you take the action. It comes like a natural thing to you. So yes, that master mariner was a requirement. But having experienced the shortage of pilots in India, particularly in the major ports, there has been a school of thought whether we should have an intake in like a Calcutta port. Calcutta port has BSc nautical or BSc, ordinary BSc graduate taking the science, and then they train them to be a pilot. But it takes fairly long time, say almost 6 to 7 years of pilotage till he becomes a full tonnage pilot. So we have been contemplating on that. And just now, for the time being, initially we thought that yes, we will go ahead for the BSc, but Then other thing what we thought is that when the pilot boards the ship, he has to interact with the master. And when the master tells you a simple thing, like, Captain, this is the, I have this kind of problem. He tells the pilot, these are the problems I have. I've given this incident. Again, a ship named Kotajaya. And at that time, the regulation of the Mumbai port was that the ship's trim should not be more than 2.8 meters. So this master, he had ballasted his forward hold. So when I boarded the ship and I gave port 10, she just did that free surface correction. So I asked Captain, what? Why your ship is behaving like this? He said, pilot, water in one number one hold. So I taken water to reduce the trim. So now at that particular time, I knew that this guy is very close to that GM, negative GM, angle of roll. And I docked the ship without use of any tug, because I knew that if I had to use the tug and ask the tug to pull the ship and stop the ship,
correct,
the ship could be in problem. So then I berthed the vessel without tug at VPX berth. So, you know, that experience, what I had known on the ship, what I learned on the ship, that I could implement it immediately at that time. So the experience, what matters, you know, the collating the experience and then putting it into the actual implementation, this is how it comes. So that particular aspect we have to take into the consideration. So we thought that BSC, yes, we take it. But then these kind of incidences or the experiences, whether nowadays the ships are much more stringently, you know, regulated, they will not have this kind of a nonsense. I would say now I can call it a nonsense, but that time it was ignorance or just trying to comply with the port regulation in the bargain, putting the ship at the risk. That's what it was exactly. Now if you look at that way. So this particular aspect, when you do a pilotage training, not only from the ship handling point, but entire total gamut of the shipping or the ship handling with other external factors like this loading a hold with water just to meet the trim requirement is something different. So in pilotage training, we have to have a kind of a encompassing all the aspects of ship stability. So when I was trying to miss, it's not that I have not done the making a model of the for pilotage. In fact, I have, I would say 60-70% of the training model for the Mumbai port, in case we decide to take the pilot from, say, second mate or mate's candidate. I have prepared that model considering all these aspects of mine, thinking that in case the guy comes across this, say for a later on, the pilot, initially he has done the pilot, but later on he comes into the managerial level and the ship comes with the wheat cargo and the guy wants it, because deputy conservator in his or harbour master or the senior dock master in his capacity has to give the permission to discharge the grain cargo at anchorage. If the stewardess or the agent, they don't comply with the stability calculation regulations, in MMD has, yes, MMD, they have to provide the calculations to MMD, submit the plan, but in actual role over there, the monitoring has to be done by the port department. And if the port department guy is not aware of the stability calculations for the cargo and not to keep the more than two hold slack, then you are inviting trouble again. So these are the small aspects of the port shipping operation got to be known to the candidate who is to be inducted in the pilot right from the bottom of the rung. So as a second mate or as a cadet, BSC Nautical, when you invite him to be a part of the pilotage cadre in port, these aspects got to be important. Now to answer the question whether it is an art or science, I would say, yes, it is an art, because how to bring the ship alongside, it is an art. Nowadays, like you heard of CAD, no? Computer aided design. So you can say the computer aided art. So it is a same thing. You can improve upon your art by taking the help of the science. That's what I would put it as. Yes, you have the use the navigation aid to improve upon your skills. Earlier, if I wanted to try a different maneuver, I could not do that by trying it actually. People would throw me out, or the pilot master will report that this pilot was crazy. In this, I'll give an example. This is a little deviating from the subject. In my company, shipping company, there was a master, a brilliant chap. He wanted to see how is the center of the storm looks like, how you feel about it. And he took the ship actually in the eye of the storm. The ship came, luckily she survived and came into the port, and first thing company did was sign him off. So what I'm going to say that this kind of thing, computer aided design, that way computer aided science, what you call, is important, because you can do, you can put into the simulator the various conditions, what you can do in case, suppose the wind is there and the engine just goes off. What kind of action you can take? How can you do it? Whether instead of using a 50-ton bowler pole, if you use a 40-ton bowler pole, how much will it take? Whether she can turn in that turning circle? All those kind of things can be tried out in the simulator, and that gives you a better kind of a confidence while you are actually doing the maneuver. So yes, it is an important aspect. That is not that you should not just have a old school of thought that no, this is an art and no need of simulators and all. Person, you train him for a long time and he will do it. Job. It's not that. In fact, the because of this simulation and other one, the person who has kind of, I've seen some of the pilots who are little, you know, hesitant or diffident about carrying out the work in the strong winds or into the strong current. So they also become a good pilot because they know what can kind of thing can happen, how much they can stretch the things far off. So this is what I say, that science, simulation and all is important aspect in training, and that should be considered. In fact, I would go further that in Mumbai port, we have started implementing that any new construction comes, before that new construction actual takes place, it's on the design board. The simulation of that area is carried out, navigation simulation, and to see how much time does the ship will take, how will she behave, what kind of action will be there. So then we consider that the structure is good, that there will be no problem in pilotage, and then we go ahead with that. So that is the new thing which has, we have started in Mumbai port now.
No, excellent, sir. Thank you very much for a very elaborate answer on that, pilot training aspect. You know, of course, you know, ship handling is a skill which is aided by the knowledge of the science of the, you know, interactions and influences on the ship. And all I believe, all the training courses of pilots do come down to that kind of a thing to pilots. But pilot must also have an internal passion, gut feeling, you know, kind of sensing, you know, as a human, intelligent human, to see that something is going wrong. Not every time the parameters would be, you know, the same. So there's also a big talk on human factor, which is what we have included in the pilot training, because human factor is one thing. You know, I don't know if you have recently seen OCIMF's, you know, complete guidelines on the human factor, right? It speaks volumes about the inclusion of human factors in shipping, and more so ever, the physiology which leads to decision making of a pilot. And you yourself have said that, you know, pilot needs to make a, you know, on the spur of a second decisions, which are very, very detrimental for safety of navigation in port. Otherwise, you know, I'm sure that port in all over the world, if pilots don't do those kind of decisions, don't take those kind of decisions, they'll be in trouble. I would let Vijay ask you the last question on the, because he's also an aspiring pilot, and Vijay's inclusion in EMPA was that because of his liking towards ship handling, and you know, as a young master mariner, he wanted to see something about the pilotage, and he saw a lot of value in EMPA, which is EMPA is adding to the pilotage world. So Vijay, all yours.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much. So as we know that there are many seafarers or there are many aspirants who are keen to join Merchant Navy, but very rarely we hear that any mariner, a seafarer wants to opt for this pilotage proposition, that is very rare. And as we all know that for to become a pilotage, the first requirement is you should love to handle ships. Ship handling is a must. And second thing is there is no substitute for experience, like you mentioned. But yes, we also should talk about the qualification that we should have to become a pilot in India. That is the minimum is the certificate of competency as a master or else chief mate with sufficient experience. But I see that the Indian pilotage is having a lot of shortages and we hear a lot of vacancies. So that is what also made me keen. And next question is regarding that, that is there any alternative methods to induct the pilots if master mariners are not coming forward? For example, we can induct a second mate with relevant rank experience who is not holding a chief mate or a master COC with necessary training. Can you elaborate something on this?
See, the first and foremost thing what I would like to ask is a general question, that why the merchant navy guy doesn't want to join a pilot as a ship handler. I view that it's not that the is ship handling may be a one issue, but in Mumbai port I've seen few pilots, they joined and left simply because they were scared of climbing and getting down the pilot ladder in monsoon winter. So it's a fact. I mean, at least I know one or two incidents. One chap has been the junior in, he joined because I joined, he joined over here, and then later on after a period of one and a half year, we see till he trained himself was okay. Then next year he started piloting, and then he faced one monsoon and he said, no sir, it's not my cup of tea getting down and climbing the pilot ladder in the monsoon. And he was frank enough to admit that. So the main thing is that facing the nature for that kind of one, because mind you, I always say that Indians as such are not, let's be frank to admit, we are not a born mariners like Westerners. That you have to admit, because it's in their blood, I would say. Whereas we are getting acquainted with it. And that is the basic difference is there. And ship handling, as I said, that you have to have frame of mind. The other thing is that compared to when a chap who is into the merchant navy and joins a pilotage, first and foremost, psychologically, he has to come down from that level of master's wages to a pilot wages. Is a real, that I used to say jokingly, and even now also I said, seriously now I say, that 6 months of training is not for the training of to be a pilot. 6 months of training is to get into the mold that yes, you want to be here for family. Yes, you want to be here for the family. And this is the best place you can be here for the family. Otherwise, that when I joined here, I still remember my wages were 1754. I cannot forget that. And my, as a master at that time, it was a salary of something like, means it was 1/10 of the wages what I was earning. 1/10 or one, means it was 1/10 or whatever. One means at least 1/4 of the wages what I'm earning, I was to earn on ship as a master. So that itself is a big come down. And that is one reason why people don't like to come down as a pilot. Unless somebody wants to have commitment assured for family and all, they take it, or very few people take it as a commitment or because they want to join pilot. The other thing what you said, people do not have fear as such, because olden days are gone. As I told you earlier, the olden days are gone of doing the pilotage with the, you know, the tugs which are there nowadays. They are much better than what we had. We had a single screw design tugs, whereas now that tugs are with the azimuth thruster, so it is much much easier piloting than the people. Then the you have the, what you call the cab, on ship also you have started having bow thruster, pitch propeller, all those kind of things are there. So it is easier now. The reason why people don't join is one thing I would say, that because of this vast difference into the salary. And second one is that the promotional aspects are there, but it takes a little longer than the normal for the, and then it is not so, what you call the salary-wise structure, it is little lesser than the other industry. Other, say, Ashore in kind of a management company. And if you put here, there would be a little difference. I'm not very sure how much it be. And regarding the inducting of second mates and mates as a pilot, we are into contemplating into that, whether we should induct and how it will be, they can be trained. We are into that point consideration, but just now we are getting Merchant Navy Master Mariners, enough of them. So we are not gone ahead with that. We can induct, and as I told you earlier in the previous question, we have to consider all aspects of ship handling, the port and shipping operations, like ship stability, how does it affect, what are the incidences, how it can work, how should you react to that one, the commercial aspect of the shipping. So module for the pilotage training would not be a just ship handling module, but it would be a kind of a complete, I would say, a sort of ship's master's certificate. Forget about the principles of navigation and all those kind of magnetism and all that kind of stuff. But part of it would be even the commercial aspect, so that guy knows what does it mean. And if suppose the ship is coming and then he has to give notice of readiness. So the pilot should be aware, what does it mean by notice of readiness? If he's not aware, then he will not do anything. In fact, another incident in this one I can give. When I was sailing as a master in Canada, I had to anchor at Vancouver, and it was a Friday evening coming close to the 1700 hours. That pilot took such a long time to anchoring, and then became, by the time we anchored, it was past 5 o'clock, 1700. And I had to give notice of readiness Saturday, Sunday, holiday excluded, and only during working hours. So my notice of readiness was tendered on Monday morning. I wrote a strong protest letter to the port authority, saying that pilot took unduly long time in anchoring, and thereby I lost my notice of readiness time. And when I told the pilot, either was he was not bothered about, or he didn't know what his notice of readiness. So you know, this kind of aspects, all those kind of things has to come into the module, and then create that one, so that when you induct the person as a candidate into your cadre, he has that total knowledge of the entire gamut of the shipping, including ship handling, then he is the right candidate for the pilot. Because I always say the pilot is the first interface of that particular port with the ship. He carries the first impression of the port and the lasting impression of the port, because he's the first one to board and last one to get out from the ship. So he has to create a good impression, and that kind of impression can be created only if the pilot is trained properly, he's confident pilot, and again, here the interpersonal relationship comes, that he knows how to behave with the pilot. With the master. Then only that pilot comes into the, you know, they carry a good impression. In this also, another example, what I say that once one ship had, actually now I think so, if you have finished, then we can, after that I can give an example. Then if you want
we just close
you can,
this.
You
we
can keep the, it. You can. You can keep it, you can record it, and if you want, you can edit it later on. Okay. So I'll tell you how the interpersonal relation or the how the thing matters. I was a full-time pilot. There was a ship at BPX, Hogue Line ships. They had those, if you are, anyone has worked on the gantry crane, which used to be a cellular vessels, like gear bulk ship, which carries the pelletized cargo. Gantry crane for pelletized cargo, that kind of crane she had. I mean, this ship had to pick up the bulldozer from the berth on board to the ship. The driver of the bulldozer was busy in the bobcat, you know, chota wala bulldozer.
Yes.
He was lazy enough to climb the gangway. He said, no, pick me up that day. And the guy picked him up. And as luck would have it, that bobcat fell between the ship and the berth in hardly a gap of about 2 or 3 feet, that fender gap, bobcat fell in that. I had just got down from the pilot launch, climbing up the steps. The control told me, sir, oh, udhar mein aadmi gir gaya pani mein, wo jahaz ko jaldi nikalo. So I rushed to the gangway. I went on board the ship. The pilot and the master got the ship ready, and we cast off the ship without any tug, anything. Within 5 minutes, we cast off the ship away from the berth. So as to see that whether the guy is alive or not. Unfortunately, that fellow passed away. And after almost 8 or 10 years, I piloted one passenger ship in. And then that captain, he said, "Pilot, why don't you come in the evening for dinner?" I said, "Why?" "Because normally I don't like to visit the ships unnecessarily." He said, "No, I have a special thing for you." Till then, he didn't tell me. He said, "Come with the family." I went in the evening on board the passenger ship. He says, "Captain, you don't remember me, but I remember you." I said, "How come?" He said, "No, you remember that? This is what happened. And you took out the ship without, and I still remember." So what I'm saying that when you carry the thing, the people do really have a lasting impression. Means I was surprised, this guy was that one, I didn't remember. He said, "Yes, I gone bald now, but you won't remember me now." But what I say is that interpersonal relationship or creating an impression on the master, taking the confidence of the master, because you see the master also, or for that matter, pilot also, when he boards the ship, he knows what kind of a person, as normal person, when you see a chap, you gauge him in the first reaction of yours is that, ye banda sahi hai, nahi hai. So that way it is. So this can be
recorded. Absolutely.
So yeah, absolutely great. But I'm saying that this is what it should be. Interpersonal relationship, yeah, in all aspects of thing, it matters. Okay. Thank you. So anything
thank you very much.
Later on you want
Vijay, let Vijay say the last few lines.
Okay. I was more impressed. Why? Because he has so much of the small examples that he has. And unfortunately, due to the time constraints, we cannot hear all those examples. But maybe someday.
So, इसको ये कहते हैं विजय कि बाल, इसको ये कहते हैं बाल सफेद, धूप में सफेद नहीं किए, बाल पोर्ट में सफेद किए.
So definitely, sir. Someday, maybe after a few months, we'll catch him again and learn more. Yeah, I am more also interested into this. He's an advisor to Mumbai Port Trust, so I would like to also know something about, you know, what role he does, what job profile is that, how he shares his experience and knowledge for this pilotage industry, being in that particular role as well. Apart from that, sir, thank you so much. It was very insightful and a lot of learning from these two episodes that we did. Thank you so much. And I'm sure all the audiences and viewers will learn and try to implement that. Like you talked about interpersonal relationship skills, which is very important. And one small example, which you mentioned, that nowadays people are busy in the cabins with their phones, laptops. Those days, earlier days, you know, the smoke room used to be filled with the crew members, and you know, that was more. So hopefully we'll see that again. And with that, thank you so much, Captain Gajanan. The floor is yours.
No, thank you very much, Anand Karkare. I mean, you've been an ardent supporter of AMPA, plus the advisor to AMPA General also, of monthly publication of ours. Thank you very much, and your insightful, the words or experiences you shared in this pilot ki baat has been very, very helpful. I'm sure viewers will like it. Thank you so much, and we'll definitely see you next time. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you. Bye.